Well, two towns in southern Maine are the primary focus in the fight against an invasive species. We spoke with the forecaster Dylan Martin earlier this week, and he explained what's happening in Harpswell and Cape Elizabeth in the effort to defeat the winter moth. And a word of caution, if you're eating, this might be the time to take a little break. Well, Dylan, first of all, thanks so much for joining us. Yeah. We do appreciate it. So let's start with exactly what are these winter moths and where'd they come from?
Well, they are originally from Europe and somehow got over here at some point. I know they had a big invasion in Nova Scotia a long time ago, but they've been big in Massachusetts for a while, and they're considered an invasive species because they can travel pretty easily by way of people transporting plant pots and stuff like that, because their cocoons are in the soil. So what happened is someone got a plant pot and there was a moth in it, and they brought it to Maine, and now they're all the way from Kittery to Bar Harbor. And so they're an invasive species and they defoliate trees, which, you know, not good for a state full trees.
So what is the state doing to combat these invasive moths?
Yeah, so the Maine Forest Service is working in concert with the University of Massachusetts Amherst and University of Maine. The University of Massachusetts Amherst has supplied the state with a few loads of these parasitic flies. They were just sent last week, and they were dispersed last week in Cape Elizabeth and Harpswell, the two areas where they are densely populated and obviously pose a higher threat. And what these flies do, it's kind of gross, but they hatch eggs onto the leaves of trees, and then the winter moth larvae eat the eggs, and then when they go into the ground to spin their little cocoon, the flies eventually hatch from within and then eat the winter moth larvae from the inside out. And then the most amazing part is that the flies will then use the cocoon over the winter to stay alive and then come out in May and then hatch eggs again and start that beautiful cycle over again.
Wow, all right. So the details not for the faint of heart if you're eating breakfast right now. But let's talk about finally a timeline for, is this going to get rid of these moths for good?
Not for good. The timeline they're looking at is within 5 years, they're hoping to level out the population to a point where the defoliation isn't as bad. The idea is that this is just one invasive species that poses a threat to Maine woods. Another one is the brown-tailed moth, but they are not as big of a threat right now. So they're trying to nip this one in the bud and hope that, you know, they don't have combined defoliators hitting the trees, which is when it can really be a threat.